A 74-year-old male is concerned about a white patch on his tongue. The full workup and treatment today on the Open Reduction. Welcome to the Open Reduction, your channel covering all topics oral and maxillofacial surgery. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten, and today I want to talk about a tongue lesion that came into my office not too long ago. This patient is a 74-year-old male who's concerned about the appearance of his tongue. He noticed this white patch a couple months ago, and it hasn't gone away. Of note in his history, he had a biopsy of this area roughly 25 years ago. He doesn't remember what the exact diagnosis was, and he has no documentation. He remembers it wasn't cancer, and he had no additional treatment afterwards. On clinical exam, we can see a very concerning lesion on his left lateral tongue. So what makes this lesion concerning? Let's start with the borders of this lesion. They're poorly defined. There is no well-delineated border. This lesion is diffuse and patchy. Second, its size. This area is measuring nearly 3 centimeters from anterior to posterior. It also extends inferiorly to the floor of the mouth. This is a large lesion for a tongue. Third, its color variation. Remember, leukoplakia is characterized by white patches in the mouth, and it's often associated with keratin thickening. There are clearly varying degrees of keratin thickening throughout this lesion, meaning the cells are not behaving in a uniform way. Fourth, there is an area of what appears to be an ulceration. This may be where the tongue is rubbing on a sharp dental cusp or filling, but it's also a red flag. An ulcer is a breakdown of the oral mucosa's epithelial lining, and this breakdown may be due to invasive cancer. It is also crucial to palpate the neck to evaluate the lymph nodes. Thankfully, I did not feel any enlarged nodes on this patient. So now that we have completed our exam, what's the next step? We need a definitive diagnosis, and this can only be reliably established with an incisional biopsy. This area is the most alarming to me. The keratin is very thick, and there's also adjacent ulceration. I take a generous tissue sample and submit it to the pathologist. You may ask, why don't I take out this lesion in its entirety? Why do I leave some behind? The reason is, I don't know what this lesion is yet, and my concern for squamous cell carcinoma, the most common type of oral cancer, is extremely high. The treatment of squamous cell carcinoma is not just removal of the lesion, it's removal of the lesion with wide margins. If this turns out to be cancer and I've removed it in its entirety, the surgical oncology team has no idea where the lesion originally was. I've done this patient a great disservice because now the borders are unknown and there's no way to confidently get clean margins. But if I only take a sample, the oncology surgeon knows exactly where the lesion is and they can resect it with appropriate margins. The pathology report on this lesion came back as severe dysplasia, which is a precancerous lesion. I was surprised. I've seen many less concerning lesions turn out to be cancer, so this was welcome news. The good thing is this hasn't progressed to cancer yet, but it will if left untreated. There are varying degrees of dysplasia, mild, moderate, and severe. Carcinoma in situ is the next stage after severe dysplasia, and after this is squamous cell carcinoma. Thankfully, we caught this one in time, but it still requires treatment. This involves either cauterization of the remaining lesion or resection. Cauterization preserves more tongue structure, but I always feel terrible for patients undergoing this type of treatment because it's very painful afterwards. Also, with a lesion of this size, it will almost certainly require multiple cauterization treatments to resolve completely. This patient had his first round of cauterization, and I'll see him back in about 2 months to reevaluate. Thanks so much for watching. Please click those like and subscribe buttons and check out my channel for other interesting OMFS cases like this one. Also, visit my website, theopenreduction.com, to help advance your clinical skills. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten. I'll catch you next time on The Open Reduction.